Welcome into the In the Money podcast for Saturday, November 2nd at Santa Anita, the second of the two Breeders' Cup days with nine Grade 1 races. Tom Leach along with Jim Goodman, Keeneland's Director of Wagering Development, who's on the scene out at Santa Anita. And we're going to take you through all of the Breeders' Cup races in a little more intense focus on the late pick four that culminates with the Classic. There are also pick fours that start in the fourth and in the sixth as well. Pick five that starts in the eighth, the pick six starts in the seventh. But Jim, we'll begin in the fourth, the filly and mare sprint at seven furlongs. Who do you like?
I like the Feffy, but I'm going to start off saying that I like a lot of favorites this weekend, and that's a scary thing. I've been talking to a lot of the players since I've been out here and been playing the BCBC where I'm working this weekend, and they feel like there's a lot of opportunity because there are a lot of strong favorites in these races, and you can get some really great prices and some really great horses. Having said that, I think Feffy, that race in the Dogwood at Churchill, sets her up perfectly for this. She's 2-for-2 at the distance, 5-for-7 lifetime. She won the test at Saratoga at 7 furlongs. I just think that the only thing I can say bad about her is that she hasn't been out here to work over the track very much. You were at her last work October 25th at Churchill. That's a question mark. But she just looks much the best in here. I'm going to use Come Dancing in multi-leg wagers just because of that class. And if she gets back to where she was back in the spring, that 114 buyer at Aqueduct, she's got a shot as well. But I think Feffy, this starts, there are all kinds of pick threes and pick fours. This actually starts a pick four in the fourth race as well. So you could do worse than singling her in this middle pick four.
I'm going to go against her. I don't like the rail post. I don't like that she's been out there not been out there training some, 3-year-old against older. So there's just a lot of reasons I want to go against her at a short price. Problem is, I really don't have a strong opinion otherwise. I ended up taking a shot with Selcourt. Bombed last year in this race, was coming off a layoff. This time, Sadler got a prep in her before this race. She's 4-4-1 in 10 starts at Santa Anita. Good record at 7 furlongs. So I'm going to take a shot with her and probably Bellafina, like a good bit, getting back on her home track. She's undefeated. She's going against older for the first time, too, but this is her home track. Come Dancing, you know, I think on her best day might be better than any of these. Leery about her on this track, but from reports, she has worked well. So got to include that one. Lady Ninja has 6 wins at Santa Anita. Spice Perfection was really good at Keeneland and has a good record at Santa Anita. So I'm going to kind of lean to the locals for the most part, other than Come Dancing, and take Selcourt and probably use 4 or 5 horse exacta box depending on prices, with maybe Bellafina, Come Dancing, and then maybe Lady Ninja. But not a real strong opinion for me on Selcourt. Turf Sprint at 5 furlongs, which is noteworthy. It's not 6.5 down the hill out here at Santa Anita anymore. It's 5 furlongs. I ended up coming back to Imprimis. I went back and watched the last 2 races at Kentucky Downs and at Keeneland. Got bad trips both times. Now they switched to Frankie Dettori. And he rode this horse over at Ascot this summer when they took the horse over there. And I like the fact that Dettori liked enough of what he felt under him that day to ride back here. And I think 5 furlongs is probably this horse's best distance. I like horses coming out of the Keeneland race, Leinster and Stubbins, who ran 2-1 in the Woodford at Keeneland. Eddie Haskell, Rosario takes off Stubbins to ride that one. Totally Boss, the other Rusty Arnold horse. Love to see Rusty Arnold get one of these races. But I'm going to take Imprimis. How about you?
I want to take the 2 horses you mentioned with the jockey changes. I think Eddie Haskell getting Rosario takes this mount and gets off Stubbins, who you won the Woodford on. But guess who gets on Stubbins? Flavian Pratt, who is the best turf jockey out here. So I'm going to do an exacta box, Stubbins and Eddie Haskell. 5-10, you got a 12-1 and a 9-2. This race is wide open. I think you can make a case for a lot of horses in here. Totally Boss, I don't like the rail position here. When she won at Kentucky Downs, he won from the outside from a 10-hole, and I don't think he's going to like the 1-hole getting stuck down there inside some pure sensations, got some speed. So I think that's going to hurt him. I'm going with Stubbins and Eddie Haskell in a very simple 5-10 exacta box. when we get to this race.
Go to the Dirt Mile, the sixth race on the card, and you've got Omaha Beach. You're going to be the favorite in there, probably, over Improbable from the Baffert Barn. How do you see it?
I got a big circle around Omaha Beach, but I've got a trifecta wheel with Omaha Beach on top, using Improbable, the two, Mr. Money, the four, who's really come a long way in the last since summer. Didn't win the Pennsylvania Derby, but almost got there, and I think he's got a big shot to run big out here. But Omaha Beach is probably the best three-year-old in the country. Hadn't had a chance to prove it because of injuries, but Omaha Beach is my pick here. I'm going to use Improbable, Mr. Money, and Giant Expectations for Ortiz. The Pat O'Brien at Del Mar was a great race. Just barely got beat by Catalina Cruiser, and I think that he's going to like the mile stretch out at a 12-1 price with Ortiz. So I'm going to use the five on top with 1-2-4 with probably everything else in the race.
I like Omaha Beach and Improbable at first glance, and then I talked myself into Spun to Run. So I think I'm going to key off that horse with those two other ones, just off that 110 buyer last time. And if that's legit, then that horse is a player. And I'm going to take a shot there for the price I'll get. He'll get overlooked, and they're switching to Irad Ortiz, which certainly doesn't hurt. So I'm going to key on Spun to Run in the Dirt Mile with the top two choices. Use all three of those if I play a pick four. Filly and Mare Turf at a mile and a quarter on the turf. Sister Charlie is the huge favorite. That's the one I picked. I couldn't make a real good case to go against her, but she's getting older with each start, and so I think if she gets beat, it's likely one of the Europeans. John Gosden and Dettori on Fanny Logan. It's a three-year-old that looks a little light on form, but just off those connections, I'm going to take a shot with that one on a ticket. Iridesa down on the inside is a grade one winning three-year-old. Villa Marina is a grade one winning three-year-old. If Sister Charlie gets beat, I think there's a good chance it might be an improving three-year-old. And then Mississippi for Graham Motion I might throw in there as well. But Sister Charlie is going to be my win pick. How about you?
You didn't mention a horse that is 11-12 at Santa Anita. Basilica?
Oh, yeah.
I don't think you mentioned her.
No,
that
I didn't.
That means this race, if you get past Sister Charlie.
It tells you where it is.
If you get past Sister Charlie in here, anybody can win the race. So you either have an opinion on singling Sister Charlie, or you have to go really deep. And this is the first leg of the pick six. I think a lot of people are going to single Sister Charlie. You could do a lot worse than take Basilica, a former claiming horse that has just killed on the West Coast this year. 18-35 lifetime, has not run this distance, so stretching out to a mile and a quarter only one time in the Rodeo Drive that was at Santa Anita, and she won here. So Basilica, I don't think you can toss her. I think she's got a shot. She's a home court advantage. Obviously, I've never seen a better home court advantage than 11-12. So I'm going to use her. Sister Charlie, if I were playing a pick six, would probably be a single. But I think this race is wide open enough that you can use other horses. Mississippi has a shot after that Flower Bowl. Only got beat by 3/4 of a length, so she's improving. Just has to get another length to beat Sister Charlie. Fleeting from Ireland, Aidan O'Brien, has a big shot. But it's either Sister Charlie or go deep here. And I'm going to throw a little bit of win money on Basilica just as a shot.
Great renewal of the Breeders' Cup Sprint at 6 furlongs. You've got Matoli, Chancelot, Imperial Hint, Catalina Cruiser. Who did you go for?
I can make a case for any of those horses, but I'm going to stick with Matoli. I think he has been the most consistent horse this year. The Vanderbilt was a throwout. He hit the gate at the start and got beat by Imperial Hint, who's a great horse, very small horse and very quick. But Matoli has done everything right this year except for that race. So I'm going to stand with Matoli here. If I were playing a pick five, I would single Matoli. Chancelot is getting a lot of buzz out here. That race that he had over the track, he didn't win, but he didn't have to. Omaha Beach comes up the inside to beat him, and that's nothing to be ashamed of. At 6 furlongs, you think Omaha Beach is going to be better going long. This horse comes back at 6 furlongs, and Omaha Beach isn't in this race. So Chancelot has a big shot here. Catalina Cruiser has a big shot. Some people have talked about Hog Creek Hustle out here as having a really working well since it's been looking well since he's been out here. So big step up in class for Hog Creek Hustle to win this. But I'm going to take a stand with Matoli here. probably playing Exacta with Chancelot below him and Imperial Hint.
Yeah, I'm on Mottoli as well. Only concern for me is that he's inside the speed from the four hole, but he's worked brilliantly and several works at Santa Anita. I like that Asmussen took his horses out there early. Chancelot got a race over the track. I don't think if that horse floated up a little bit, I might get a little intrigued with that one. Catalina Cruiser's 2-for-2. Imperial Hint, very, very good horse. So I'll probably just, I mean, Mottoli's my win pick in multi-race wagers. I just take all four and not try to outthink it and try to hit a price somewhere else. Let's go to the ninth race. It's the mile. This starts the late pick four that culminates with the classic. And I think there's a good chance you could catch a nice price in here. But that being said, I went for a lower price coming off just an incredible performance at Keeneland was Uni. She was so visually impressive. I actually had got Stormy in the four-star Dave when she beat the boys up at Saratoga. And she's my second pick. But I was so impressed with Uni's run at Keeneland. She's 6-of-7 at a mile that I'm going to take Uni over Got Stormy in here. But there's another Chad Brown that I think we should watch, and that's a 20-to-1 horse Without Parole. Been off since May. First time for Chad Brown. This horse looked like he was really something special over in Europe at 3 and won a Group 1 at Royal Ascot. And then whatever happened, the horse ends up in Chad Brown's barn. And they come back off a layoff in the Grade 1 Breeders' Cup mile. And if it was anybody other than Chad Brown, I probably wouldn't pay much attention. But I'm going to definitely not let that one beat me. Circus Maximus, as a 3-year-old, I think might be vulnerable. I don't think Aiden O'Brien's got an especially good record in this particular race. Soudois off the Keeneland race could be okay as a hit-the-board kind of horse. But, again, I'm just kind of all over the place. I'm going to end up taking a win pick with Uni and hope I could get With Parole in there somewhere. How about you?
I liked Uni, but I actually liked another horse coming out of the Keeneland races a little bit better, Bowie's Hero. I thought the Shadwell Turf, he came from way out of it with Flavian Pratt up, comes back at the same distance, beat Soudois in that race, and I thought showed a lot of guts coming from out of it. So I don't think the 14 hole is going to hurt him that much. He comes from behind anyway. So I'm going to take Bowie's Hero on top here, but I'm going to use a bunch of horses in the pick four. I'm going to use Uni, the horse that you mentioned, Got Stormy for Mark Cassie. Lord Glitters, the 12 for Jamie Spencer is riding for O'Meara, has got a lot of back class. Got some nice time form figures. Got a 122 in the Queen Anne Stakes at Ascot back in June and won by a neck over 16 horses. Then I'm going to use Circus Maximus just because I'm like you. I don't think a 3-year-old is going to win this, but his form is too much, too good to throw out. And then I'm going to throw in my long shot. I've got noticed Without Parole is Tom Leach's long shot here. So I may not let him beat me either, but I'm not going to let Bolo beat me on this racetrack. Bolo is 30-to-1, 5-for-11 at Santa Anita, 4-for-12 at the distance. It's Le Peru, who's been riding lights out back east, and not a bad hunch bet here for Bolo. He won the Shoemaker Mile here at 30-to-1 for Giroux back in May. Had a couple races since then, and I think might be sitting on a big one at 30-to-1. So Bolo is going to be my long shot here. But going to go 6 deep when we get to pick 4.
Yeah, one other one. I had Lord Glitters and Space Traveler, another Euro in here. I'm going to go deep the pick 4, and definitely going to have some European flavor in there. 10th race is the Distaff at a mile and an eighth. Midnight Bisou, the big favorite. Can you beat her?
I think you can. I think a lot of people will single Midnight Bisou, but when you're looking at value in the pick 4, if you can beat a horse like that, you can make some money. And I think we've got two shots here with horses that came out of the Keeneland races. Blue Prize, the 11 for Joe Bravo, who won the Spinster, and Dunbar Road, the 3-year-old for Chad Brown, who was touted that day and went off as second choice to a late and ran a good third, came up the rail, just had a little bit of an odd trip. It was on the inside in a 5-horse field. I think she steps forward off that race, and she can make a lot of noise in here. Midnight Bisou is the obvious favorite and should be on a 7-race win streak, 7-for-7 in 2019. Probably has a shot to to get horse of the year if the 3-year-olds don't take it away from her. And I think she's got a real shot. If she goes 8-for-8 with this one, it'd be hard to bet against her. But I'm not going to single her here. I'm going to use Dunbar Road, and I'm going to use Blue Prize, the surprise winner over Elate in the Spinster, as my surprise horse in this one. I think with those three, though, I've got it covered. Paradise Woods is my next choice. Never know which one's going to show up, but she's certainly capable on her best day for John Sheriff's. I'm going to stick with those three, Midnight Bassoon, Dunbar Road, and Blue Prize.
I am going to take Dunbar Road in here. I don't think the inside was the best place to be on Spinster Day, and she was just kind of trapped in there the whole way until she got into the stretch and gets her regular rider back in Jose Ortiz. He did not ride her that day. And the Spinsters, since back to the original Breeders' Cup day at Hollywood Park, has been the premier prep for the distaff. And we've been more than once that a horse has come out of a non-winning effort at the Spinster and jumped up and won the distaff. So that's what I'm going to pick Dunbar Road to do. Midnight Bisou obviously would have to use. And I'll probably just stand with those two on when we get to the pick four. Paradise Woods, just on the 5 wins at Santa Anita, I think merits a look as well. The turf at 1.5 miles, I ended up going to Old Persian here. I think Bricks and Mortar could be vulnerable. He's never even run at 1.5 miles, much less won at it. Now, he's has a sensational year. Chad Brown's his trainer, so he'll probably win. But I'm going to try a couple of Euros to beat him. Old Persian has 5 wins at 1.5 miles. The trainer, Charlie Appleby, has a really good record in Breeders' Cup races. And then Aiden O'Brien has a wonderful record in this race on the Breeders' Cup card. He's got Anthony Van Dyke with 2 wins at 1.5 miles. So I'm going to take those 2 Euros, key on those pretty hard, over Bricks and Mortar because of the distance question. But I'll use all 3 on my pick 4 ticket. How about you in the turf?
I like Bricks and Mortar, but I've got the same question that you do with 1.5 miles. He's been so consistent, and so Chad Brown is the best turf trainer in the world. Right now, so I'm going to go with Bricks and Mortar here, but I'm going to throw in only one other horse when I get to my pick 4, and that's one that you didn't mention. I like Arklow. Arklow stretched out to 1.5 miles the last 2 times, ran at Kentucky Downs, didn't much care for that turf course, but came back at Belmont and won the Turf Classic, the Grade 1, got a 104 buyer. He's moving in the right direction here. A lot of these horses have beaten him, but I'm going to throw him in there for a long price, the 11, Arklow. And I'm going to box him with Bricks and Mortar and the exact and play him on top and tries.
And that brings us to the 1.25 miles Breeders' Cup Classic, the culmination of a fantastic card out at Santa Anita. Jim, how do you see the Classic?
Well, one of my duties at Breeders' Cup this year is to work the Breeders' Cup handicapping contest. And everybody knows that this is the way the handicapping contest will be decided. You got to have enough money at the end to fire at this one. And I wish I had a better opinion, but I've got a bunch of horses singled here. McKenzie's going to be the favorite for Baffert, and not a lot to argue against McKenzie, except for he's 0-for-2 at the distance. I think he's best at 1.8 miles. Can he get 1.25 miles on this track? Absolutely. But I don't think he's going to provide any value, and I think at the end of the day, you need to look for value in this race. I think there's a couple of horses that I like here. Vino Rosso is 4-to-1 morning line, but may drift up a little higher if McKenzie gets played heavier. And I thought that Jockey Club Gold Cup was an absolute great run for him. Obviously, he got disqualified and placed second behind Code of Honor in a very controversial call. But that's his second off a layoff. He ran well in the Whitney behind McKenzie and Yoshida. If he moves forward off those races, he's got a big shot out of here. And Code of Honor has a big shot, but the running style doesn't really worked that well on this racetrack in the past. We'll see how it goes this weekend. McKenzie, obviously. I think Elate has a shot here. The filly against the boys, it's something that she's biting off a big chunk here, but she's better at 1.25 miles than she is at 1.8 miles, and she doesn't have to face Midnight Bisou in here. So I think Elate's got a shot. Entire power for John Sadler after that Pacific Classic win back at Del Mar at 1.25 miles. Getting a lot of steam out here, even though he did not run that well in the Awesome again on this racetrack. And then Yoshida for Belmont. Belmont gets him ready. This horse has been off since August. But coming back off a layoff, he's run well off a layoff before. He's got a lot of closing kick and might set up well for him. So I'm going to go about 6 deep here. If you made me pick a winner, I would probably go with Vino Rosso or Code of Honor.
I am on Elate. Bill Mott wanted to run the Classic last year at Churchill, and it didn't work out. So he gets to run here. She's 3-for-3 at the distance. She has been so close to a big win, and maybe getting to this distance will be the key. The workout at Churchill, 34-3 on October 19th. That's un-Mott-like, and you know something that's out of the norm for an exceptional trainer usually catches my eye. So I thought that was intriguing. Got to use McKenzie on my ticket, and Vino Rosso's won at 1.25 on that track, so I'll have both of those. I like Higher Power. If he can get back anywhere close to that Pacific Classic win, and he had trouble at the start last time, then I think he's a major player. So definitely we'll use those four. And then for my I'm going to use probably one more in there. And I started to make it at Yoshida. I'm going to change to Seeking the Soul. Dallas Stewart took this horse out to California early to get acclimated. Last race was just a pure prep. And, Dallas, this probably is a horse more to hit the board than to win. But in case he would jump up and win it at a huge number, I'm going to have him on my ticket as well. So I'm probably going to use that one instead of Yoshida. And I'll stop at 5 in the Classic just to keep the ticket affordable. So let's go to the 9th race. Give me your late pick 4 ticket.
All right, late pick 4 ticket. Went 6 deep in the 9th with 6, 7, 9, 11, 12, 14. I like Uni in there a lot. I like Bolo, got Stormy. But deep here, and probably my win pick is Bowie's Hero, the 14. So 6, 7, 9, 11, 12, 14. In the distaff, I'm sticking with 3 horses. The 4, 5, 11, Midnight Bisou, Dunbar Road, and Blue Prize. In the turf, I'm going 2 deep there with Ricks and Mortar, the 9, and the 11, Arclow. And then in the Breeders' Cup Classic, I'm going 6 deep with 5, 6, 7, 8, 10, 11, Yoshida, Elate, Higher Power, McKenzie, Vino Rosso, and Code of Honor. So that is a 6, 7, 9, 11, 12, 14 with 4, 5, 11, with 9-11, with 5-6-7-8-10-11 for $108.
I am going to go with a bigger ticket than I typically would. I'm going to use 7 in the mile, try to catch a price, because I don't have a real strong opinion there. I'm going to use 1-3-6-9-10-11-12, then just the 2 I mentioned, Midnight Bisou and Dunbar Road, 4 and 5 in the distaff leg. Third leg, 5-9-10, the 2 Euros and Bricks and Mortar. And then in the Classic, 2-6-7-8-10. So that's $105. If you want to trim the ticket down a little bit, you could leave out Seeking the Soul and just go 6-7-8-9. But I'm going to go 2-6-7-8-10, 5 horses in the last leg for a $105 ticket. It's a great day if you can just be right a couple of times on a wager. You could have a really nice day, more than that, and it could be a huge day. You hit one or two of these multi-races. I know, Jim, you like to play rolling pick threes, like small pick three tickets, and then if you can hit two or three of those on a day, it could be some big numbers. So,
The pick fours and pick fives are so tough to get, and I'll obviously take a shot at those, but I love to play rolling pick threes. For example, if you love Sister Charlie, you can bet her at the end of a pick three, in the middle of a pick three, and the start of a pick three. And catch some prices, and it's remarkable what they will pay in these big fields.
So enjoy the day. It's a handicapper's delight, and best of luck, and make sure that you get your Keeneland Select account funded early so you're ready to go for Friday and Saturday at the Breeders' Cup. For Jim Goodman, I'm Tom Leach, and this is the End the Money Podcast for KeenelandSelect.com.